trying to demystify autofocus area modes. This is different than autofocus modes, which tells your camera what to do when you press down on your focus button. That is, whether to focus once or to continually refocus on your subject. Now, autofocus area modes tells your camera where to focus when you press down on your focus button. Your camera has several autofocus area modes to choose from, but they all fall within three basic categories. They go from a very tiny area to a larger zone to a very wide area. Let's start with small spot or point. When you select small spot, you are telling your camera the exact spot you want it to focus on. You can move that spot around with the pad on the back of your camera. Your camera will not focus on anything outside of that spot. It's very accurate, but very, very hard to keep on a moving subject. When you select one of the zone modes, your camera will decide what to focus on within that zone, which will appear as a boundary box in your viewfinder. You may see the focus points jump around as you press down on your focus button. It can also be moved around on the pad of the back of your camera. When you select wide autofocus area mode, it lets your camera decide what it thinks you want it to focus on within your entire image. It's great for birds in the sky or a dog running on a sandy beach, but it's not good for complex scenes. How does your camera decide what to focus on? It may focus on the closest thing to you, or what has the most contrast, or even a combination. Here's something to remember. Does your camera have the auto eye detection feature? It will only work if your subject's eyes are within the autofocus boundary. What should you set your autofocus area mode on? It's best to start small and work your way larger, but it really depends on what your subject is and the entire scene surrounding your subjects. Do you want to find out more about your camera's focus features? Come into Horn Photo and ask our experts. Got the picture?